为昆大之音服务员聆听，各位尊敬的外山赴任者，今天是2021年10月19日，我们又非常非常荣幸地邀请到了圣巴伊维纳维纳什拉辛卡索马拉给我们讲今天的大国家瓦坦早课，敬请聆听。还是第十。
Om Magyanat Marandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militanena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschachate Shatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the pastime of the speaking of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, which is a book written by Sanatana Goswami. And we're hearing about the glories of the people of Vrindavan. At this point, the glories of Vrindavan are being described by the ladies of Mathura. So the ladies of Mathura, they were appreciating how fortunate the ladies of Vrindavan are.
Mathura 的女士们，她们就开始对文达文的女士们的幸运大加赞赏。
They said that the ladies of Vrindavan are the most fortunate of all women because their minds are fully attached to Krishna.
她们说，文达文的女士们是最幸运的女士了。因为他们的心意全然依附于 Krishna.
They're always singing about Krishna when they're doing their different duties, like milking the cows or crushing the grains or churning the butter.
他们恒常的在唱诵着 Krishna. 当他们做家务活的时候，就当他们挤奶，或者是碾压谷物、搅拌黄油之际。
And sometimes they have to gather, of course, every day they have to gather the cow dung, which they use for the fuel.
每天呢，他们都要搜集牛粪饼儿，因为他们要用牛粪饼做燃料。
And sometimes they're taking care of the babies, and they have to pour water on the ground to stop the dust all coming up.And they have to clean their houses, they have to do many duties, but their minds are always fixed on Krishna. So, even in the course of doing all of their different duties which they have to do, the gopis, they never forget Krishna.
Even
Even though they cannot see Krishna, but they don't forget him. They see him in their heart. So they're always doing sankirtan, even when the circumstances don't really allow it. Sometimes, of course, they're making garlands for Krishna. At that time also, they'll be chanting his names and singing his glories. So Krishna, he would sing, Krishna himself would sing about the beautiful moon and about the light of the moon in the autumn season and the lotus flowers.
Krishna本人,他也会歌颂秋月,以及池塘中绽放的莲花。But
the gopis, they don't sing about these things. They simply sing about Krishna. They sing Krishna's name again and again. Krishna would sing a song about the Rasa dance, but the gopis, they would just sing Krishna, Krishna. They would just sing the names of Krishna.
Krishna 会歌颂 Rasa 之舞，但是勾品们，他们会反反复复地唱诵着 Krishna, Krishna.
So the ladies of Mathura, they're describing how fortunate these ladies in Vrindavan are. And when they talk about the ladies of Vrindavan, they include all the women, not just the gopis, but even the tribal or the aborigine women. So all the women who come in contact with Krishna, some are in the forest, and whether they have children or they're young girls or old women, they all become rich in the highest love of Krishna.
所有跟 Krishna 接触的妇女，不管是年轻的小孩子、小女孩，还是年轻的少女，或者是年长的女士们，她们都充盈着对 Krishna 的爱，最高的爱的滋味。
So only the women of Vrindavan have this luck, not other ladies, no other place.
只有在文达文的妇女女士才有这种幸运好运，而其他地方的女士们并没有她们这么好运。
What is their good fortune? Their good fortune is that they always do Krishna Sankirtan. No matter what else they do, they always do Krishna Sankirtan.
他们的好运是在哪方面体现的呢？因为他们总是在从事着 Krishna Sankirtan，无论他们做什么事情，他们总是在从事 Krishna Sankirtan.
They have to do many duties, take care of the cows, and they have to help their husbands, and they take care of their children.
他们有许许多多的家务活要干，他们要照料母牛，他们还要照顾自己的丈夫、孩子们。And
they have to put their makeup on. They have things like kumkum and chandan and they have to put these things on their bodies.
这些女士们，她们还要涂抹化妆品。 他们要涂上粉扑粉、穿的红香粉和其他的化妆品在身上。
But all the time they're singing Krishna's names when they're cooking and when they're cleaning and everything they're doing, they're always chanting the names of Krishna.
但是他们始终在唱诵着，在他们做饭的时候啊，还是在做其他的家务活的时候。
So, although they're doing many things, it's not a problem to them. They can still remember Krishna and they feel ecstasy chanting the names of Krishna. And they don't mind doing all these duties. They don't think, I just want to chant Krishna's name. They think all of these different things which they're doing is an opportunity for them to sing about Krishna. And because they're so absorbed in singing about Krishna, they don't feel tired from all the work they're doing. And because they're so absorbed in their singing, they actually see Krishna.
因为他们唱诵的太专心了，实际上他们真正的就看见了Krishna。They
see him in their hearts.
他是在他们自己的内心看见了他。
Sometimes they make excuses to go and directly see Krishna.
有的时候他们也会找借口去偷偷的去见，直接去见Krishna。
Sometimes there are elder people around and the gopis feel a little shy to sing about Krishna. So then they have to keep Krishna in their heart, in their mind. They just worship Krishna and sing about Krishna in their mind.
他们就把 Krishna 放在自己的心意里，他们就在心意里来崇拜 Krishna， 唱诵 Krishna。
So this way, the gopis chant about Krishna. Their minds are more and more attracted to him.
勾皮们就这样唱着 Krishna 的名字，他们的心意变得越来越被 Krishna 吸引。
They can't think about anything else except Krishna. Sometimes they cry. They shed tears thinking about Krishna.
那除了 Krishna 之外，他们想起别的来，有的时候他们会一边这样唱着，一边就流着泪。So
this is why they are the most fortunate women, because they always see Krishna, always chant his name, always think about him, and are completely attracted to him.
这就是这温达文的高品们幸运所在，他们总是在唱着他的名字，总是在内心看见他，总是时刻的想着他。And
their love for Krishna is pure love. It's not like what we think of love in the material world.
他们对 Krishna 的爱是纯粹、纯洁无瑕的爱。
So, there may be some doubt. We may think, well, you know, when a woman does certain work, doesn't she do it because she's attracted to doing it, right? Women do certain activities because they like to do it. Like some women, they like to cook. Some women, they enjoy cleaning and Women also, of course, they love their children so much. So don't they just do these things because they like doing it?
那么接下来就有个疑惑了，这些女人们，她们比如说她们在做饭，她们清洁房间或者照料孩子，难道她们不是出于自己的喜好在做这些事吗？
So how can we say that they're really absorbed in love of Krishna?
那我又怎么能说她们是全神贯注于 Krishna 呢？
But the Mathura ladies, the Mathura ladies who are describing about the glories of the gopis of Vrindavan, they say, yeah, but look at the tears in their eyes. That proves how much pure love they have for Krishna.
这些玛图热的女人们就以如下的答案来回复这个疑惑，她们说：“你们必须要观察勾屁们眼中的泪花，这些泪花就证明了她们对Krishna的全然的吸引。”
And so the gopis, they do all of these different duties, all the things which they do at home and taking care of children, everything. They do all of that just for the sake of Krishna.
这些勾屁们，他们无论是照料孩子，还是从事别的家务职责，他们只是为了Krishna而做的。
But we may wonder, well, if their minds are so disturbed with, if their minds are so distracted about Krishna, how can they properly do their duties to take care of their bodies and take care of their families?
那么又有另外一个疑惑出来了，如果这些勾屁们他们是如此的三心二意，三心二意，他们心意里有别的想法，那这些勾屁们他们在执行他们的家务职责的时候，他们是怎么维持自己的身体，又怎么来维系其他的职责的呢？
So we should remember who is Krishna, that Krishna has amazing energies and he can do wonderful activities.
那么我们就要看一看到底Krishna是何许人也吧。Krishna他拥有令人惊讶的能量，他能从事其地。So
because the gopis fix their mind on Krishna, they're able to do their duties and at the same time to remember him.
所以当这些勾屁们，他们一方面全身心的想着Krishna，而且与此同时又能轻而易举的来执行他们其他的职责。So
they're always thinking of Krishna, and so they don't have any anxiety about all the other things which they're supposed to do.
这些勾屁们 他们从始至终都在想着Krishna，而且他们并不担心他们必须要履行的其他的义务。Everything
they do is for his satisfaction.
他们的一切所作所为都是为了Krishna的快乐和满足。And
everything they do it very nicely, very expertly, because they're so Krishna conscious.
而且他们无论做什么事情， 他们都是这么精湛，做得又那么出色，只是为了让Krishna满意。
So the gopis, when they sing about Krishna, it's very, very special.
所以，gopi们对Krishna的唱诵是独一无二的。And
they remember Krishna, and they actually see Krishna in their hearts. This is the result of all of their singing and service to Krishna.
这些勾屁们，他们在内心在观看着Krishna，同时呢，他们就完全的专注于Krishna，这是他们唱诵Krishna、想念Krishna的结果。So
the ladies of Mathura, they say, these women of Vrindavan, they are the most fortunate, ways which we can never hope. We can never hope to be like them.
所以马图拉的女人们就这样下结论说，文达文的这些妇女们是最幸运的人们了，他们的幸运是我们所望不可及的。
No, we're very unfortunate. How sad.
我们太不幸了，多么令人悲叹。
So when the young gopis hear Krishna playing his flute, when he goes out at Vrindavan in the morning, he goes out with the cows to the forest, and they hear him playing the flute, and then he will come back in the evening, then the gopis again, they'll come out of their houses just to see him.
这些年轻的 gopi 们清晨的时候在 Krishna 带着母牛前往森林之际，他们听到 Krishna 的吹奏着笛子，而到傍晚的时候 ，Krishna 返回村子的时候，这些 Gopi 们又迅速地跑出家去看他。
So these Gopis who are seeing Krishna like that every day, they must have performed many, many pious activities.
能如此地看见 Krishna、目睹 Krishna 的这些 Gopi 们。
They're able to see Krishna walking on the road, and he will see them, he will smile at them and look on them. They're so fortunate.
These 牧牛姑娘们就能看见 Krishna 行走在路上的姿态，看见 Krishna 对他们的瞥视，他们是多么的幸运啊。
So the ladies of Mathura say, well, we also get the chance to see Krishna when he's walking on the road. And we are able to glorify him. We can also do some chanting of his holy names.
Mathura 的女士们又接着说，而我们这些 Mathura 的女人们也有这个特权，能看见 Krishna 行走在路上的样子，也能唱诵他的名字来荣耀他。
We can do like the gopis. When we do our activities, we can also sing his names.
就像 gopi 们一样，当我们从事活动的时候，我们也能与此同时唱诵他的名字。
But it doesn't mean we'll get the same experience as the gopis get when they chant the holy names.
但是并不等于我们得到的体验跟那些 gopi 们唱诵 Krishna 的名字的体验是相等的。
Because the gopis, they're able to watch Krishna in the morning when he goes off to the forest, and then they see him in the evening when he comes back.
因为当清晨 Krishna 离开家的时候，这些 Gopi 们都用目光远送着 Krishna， 送着 Krishna。而当 Krishna 在夜晚返回家的时候，他们又用目光迎接他们回家。
So they see him surrounded with all the cows and the cowherd boys。
这些 Gopi 们就看见 Krishna 四周簇拥着那些母牛和他的牧牛童朋友。
And Krishna will be playing his flute.And when the gopis hear the flute, then they all come outside to see Krishna.
Krishna 吹奏着他的笛子，笛音传到牧牛姑娘的耳中的时候，他们就离开家，跑到门外来看 Krishna.
So these women, they may not be very strong, and they may not be independent, but they are still the most fortunate ladies.They must be the most pious of all human beings.
这些妇女们，她们并不是那么身强力壮，她们也不能独立自主，但是她们依然是最幸运的人，她们一定是人类当中最虔诚的人。
They not only see Krishna, they hear his flute,And they even hear the jingling of his foot bells as he walks on the road.
他们不仅能目睹 Krishna, 他们还能聆听到 Krishna 的笛音。他们甚至能看见 Krishna 行走在路上的时候，听到他的脚踝上佩戴着叮当的铃声。
And Krishna's face is always smiling. He's always very blissful.
And Krishna's
But the gopis, when they're looking at Krishna, they're in anxiety because they know that he will soon be out of their sight. He will go off into the forest and they won't see him again until the evening when he comes back. So what is auspicious about being left in separation from Krishna? But anything in connection with Krishna is auspicious, even when it may appear to be like suffering. They see him leave in the morning, but they see him come back again in the evening. So the gopis spend the whole day in feelings of separation from Krishna. Just like the lotus flower, when it's exposed to the sunlight, it becomes almost dead.
就像莲花暴露在日光下的时候，几乎就死去了。So
the gopis are like that when they see Krishna go off to the forest.
勾品们看见 Krishna 走进森林的情景的时候，就像莲花一般。And
each time they see Krishna, it's like a festival for them. Every morning, they will make excuses to come to see Krishna.
而看到 Krishna 对勾品来说就是一个节日，他们每天早晨都会找种种的借口去亲自去看 Krishna.
They'll come to Mother Yashoda's house and they'll see Krishna, and then when Krishna gets ready to go into the forest, they'll follow him for a little bit until he enters the forest.
他们会找借口去亚洲的妈妈的家去看 Krishna. 而当 Krishna 启程去森林的时候，他们又在随后尾随在他的身后。
So they're always thinking about how to get out of their houses and how to get near to Krishna.
他们总是在琢磨着怎么才能离开自己的家，怎么接近 Krishna.
And when they hear Krishna's flute, they run out of their houses. The sound of the flute gives them, it awakens it, the desire of Cupid in their heart.
他们一听到 Krishna 吹奏笛子的时候，立刻就奔出家门，这个笛就唤起他们内心的爱的丘比特。
And they feel helpless, they feel weak, hearing the sound of Krishna's flute.
每当听到 Krishna 的笛音的时候，他们就感到那么无助，那么的脆弱。
So the gopis get the greatest mercy of Krishna when they feel that separation from Krishna. So these ladies of Mathura, they're describing the ecstasy of seeing Krishna. The ladies of Mathura, they cannot understand the feeling of the separation from Krishna. And they don't even dare to talk about Krishna's rasa dance. It's it's so difficult just to speak about Krishna. Just seeing Krishna is so difficult for the Mathura women to describe, that it's impossible for them to even think about Rasa Leela.
仅仅是看见 Krishna 这个场景，对 Mathura 的女人们来说都很难以描述，那么更何况谈论Krishna 的 Rasa 之舞呢？
The ladies are talking about being able to see Krishna, but the gopis don't just see Krishna. They can dance with Krishna, and they're embraced by Krishna.
Mathura 的女人们，她们只能谈论着看见 Krishna， 而 Vrindavan 的女士们，她们还在 Krishna 可以共舞，她们还得到 Krishna 的拥抱。
So the ladies of Mathura, they say, our pious activities are so few, we're so limited in our pious activities that we are not qualified to be able to see Krishna like the gopis. So in this way, the ladies of Mathura were glorifying the gopis of Vrindavan. Now we're going to hear about how Krishna appreciates the love of his devotees. Krishna is going to describe his own glories, his own loving relationship with his devotees.
Krishna 将描述他自己的荣耀。
And Krishna says, I'm indebted to the gopis because they give me so much love and I cannot repay the debt.
Krishna
said, even in a lifetime of Brahma, I cannot repay everything I owe you. Because Krishna said, you've worshipped me and you gave up, you cut off all of your connections with the family and material world, which are very difficult to give up.
Krishna said, 因为你们崇拜我, 你们切断了物质世界难以切断的所有的家庭关系。
So you'll have to be satisfied with your own activities as compensation.
所以你们就可以对自己的活动感到心满意足，以此作为对你们的报答。
So this is describing the position of the gopis who have so much pure love for Krishna.
Right.
When Krishna had called the gopis to the forest, Krishna was playing the flute in the middle of the forest and the gopis heard it and they all came running to the forest to be with Krishna. In the night.
在夜深人静的时候, Krishna 吹起了笛子, 而牧牛姑娘纷纷地奔出家门, 在夜深人静的时候, 跟Krishna在一起。
Yeah, Krishna was calling them to come for the rasa dance. So they came, but then Krishna disappeared.
Krishna在呼唤着牧牛姑娘前来跟他共跳rasa之舞, 但突然之间,
So when Krishna disappeared, the gopis cried. They were in pain from separation of Krishna.
When Krishna 突然消失之际, 姑娘们深深地感受到与Krishna分离之情，不禁流下了泪水。
So then, after some time, Krishna reappeared, and he sat with all the gopis, and he listened to all their questions.
之后，Krishna又重新地出现了，他坐在gopi们的中间，聆听gopi们的问题。
So Krishna spoke this, he was speaking about how he's indebted to them. This was his reply, how he replied to their questions.
So this is Krishna answering the question.
The gopis were trying to understand Krishna's dealings with them. So the gopis are completely faultless in their love for Krishna. They don't do anything wrong. Their only thought is how to make Krishna happy. So the gopis shouldn't be criticized for approaching Krishna. It's not that they're lusty. Their lust for Krishna is the greatest virtue, is the highest quality. The gopis' attraction to Krishna is the development of their love of God. And that's why Krishna considered himself unable to repay his debt to them. Krishna says he's unable to repay the gopis for their devotion.
Krishna said he
So Krishna says he cannot show the same qualities as the gopis, Krishna cannot do like them.
Krishna 说他没办法就像牧牛姑娘，做出牧牛姑娘的举动，他无法拥有牧牛姑娘那样的品格。
Yeah, what they're doing for him, he cannot do for them. So Krishna's surprised that the gopis are so committed to Krishna that they want to do so much, they give up everything for him. They left their homes and their husbands and their children just to be with Krishna. So they worship Krishna so perfectly. Their love for him cannot be compared to anybody else's love. But Krishna has ties, Krishna has many devotees, and Krishna feels affection for all of these different devotees.
是 Krishna 有不同种类的奉献者，他对这些不同种类奉献者都深怀爱意。
The gopis, they only love Krishna, but Krishna cannot say, I just only love the gopis. Krishna cares for all of his devotees.
Gopi 们唯独爱 Krishna, 但是 Krishna 爱他所有的奉献者，他不能说他只爱 Gopi。
So there's nothing Krishna can do to reciprocate to the love of the gopis.
所以 Krishna 在回报木牛姑娘这方面他是无能为力的。
This is why Krishna said, I'm in debt to them, I cannot repay them.
正是由于这个原因 Krishna 对他们说，我无法报答你们，我无法回报欠你们的情。
So the gopis, they, of course, they're doing things which appear to be not very good.For example, you know, some of the things which they're saying to Krishna, that they're behaving cruelly towards Krishna.
Gopi 们就对 Krishna 说话当中表达了他们对 Krishna 是残忍。
But these things are actually glorious also.
但实际上这些也都是光荣的。
So the pious activities of the gopis.Krishna says, this is the gopis' greed to, Krishna has agreed to enjoy with the gopis in all situations.
Krishna 在任何情况下他都贪婪的想要跟公平们一起享受。
Krishna doesn't care how they treat him. He wants to enjoy with them.
Krishna 不在乎公平们怎样对待他，他只想跟公平们一起欢乐。
The gopis, they have offered their bodies to Krishna.And Krishna should actually repay them.
Gopi 们把自己的身体都献给了 Krishna. 那 Krishna 本来应该就回报他们。
But Krishna has his own duties. Krishna has his own, he has his household duties. He has to take care of the cows. He cannot just give up all his responsibilities and just go and be with the gopis.
可是 Krishna 也是有责任在身的，他还要照料母牛，他不能把这些责任撇到一边不管，只是跟Gopi们在一起。
Krishna might be able to put aside his attachment to these other things, but he cannot avoid being involved with them.His responsibilities and so on. He cannot just simply give all these things up. He may give up his attachment to them in his heart, but he cannot just leave them. He has to show some concern for his duties.
Krishna 可以在内心不依附他所从事的种种的职责，但是他必须要用他的身体，Krishna 必须要不能 Krishna 不能避免就是外在的卷入到所有这些职责活动当中。
So Krishna says, he said, the gopis they give up everything for me. He said, I can't do like what they did. But Krishna promised in the Bhagavad Gita. In the Bhagavad Gita, he made a vow. He said, "Yeyata mam prapadyante tam stataiva bhajami aham." He said, "As you surrender unto me, I reward you accordingly." But Krishna cannot keep that promise because the gopis surrendered so much. Krishna cannot do like them. So Krishna is very humble and he requests them to agree to be satisfied with their own good qualities.
Krishna 非常的谦卑, 他就请求牧牛姑娘们为自己的品格而感到心满意足。
But he also suggests, he said, "I may not be able to reciprocate properly with you, but in the future, some of my devotees will become followers of the gopis, and they will serve them faithfully." So in this way, the devotees of the gopis will repay Krishna's debt to the gopis.
Krishna 尽管他自身无法回报，充分的回报牧牛姑娘们，但是也许在将来，他的奉献者们会成为牧牛姑娘的追随者们，而且忠实的服务这些牧牛姑娘，以此方式来回报这些勾体。So
Krishna has a secretary called Uddhava. So Krishna, one day he told his secretary Uddhava, he said, "I want you to go to Vrindavan and give pleasure to our parents. And I want you to relieve the gopis of their suffering and separation by giving them my message."
Krishna 给我们的父母带来欢乐，与此同时缓解那些处在分离的痛苦当中的牧牛姑娘的那些情绪。So
what we say about someone when that person is absent is that it indicates our true feelings.
在的时候，我们对他在他们背后所说的话，就揭示了我们对他们的真实的内心情感。But
if we're in his presence, we may not say so openly.
但是当着他们的面，我们可能不会那么开诚布公。So
Krishna is saying things about the gopis which are very special, very confidential.
Krishna 对牧牛姑娘所说的这些话都是机密的。
And it shows us that Krishna certainly feels indebted to them, just like he was saying.
他就表明 Krishna 无疑感觉自己亏欠了这些牧牛姑娘，就像他嘴上所说的那样。
So Krishna wanted to do what would help the gopis most to get his greatest mercy.
Krishna 就希望采取一些行动来帮助勾聘们获得他全部的仁慈，最大的仁慈。
So he thought the best thing to do is said that he didn't want to, he said the best thing is to send Uddhava there to Vrindavan, not that he go himself, but that he sends Uddhava there.
所以 Krishna 他就派 Uddhava 去 Vrindavan, 而不是他亲自去本大本。
And he gave Uddhava a message to deliver to the gopis, and that message was to pacify the Brijbasi people from the pain of separation.
Krishna 就给 Uddhava 一条信, 给 Uddhava, 让 Uddhava 烧气儿, 去安慰那些 Vajravasi, 去缓解, 那些 牧牛姑娘与她的分离的痛苦。
And the message was to encourage them and to give them hope that they would see him again.
这条信息是为了鼓励他们, 给他们带来, Krishna 重逢的希望。
So Krishna, in the beginning, he is describing the ordinary dealings by asking Uddhava to go to comfort his mother and father.
那么一开始呢，Krishna就按照普通的日常交往的方式，请求Uddhava去安抚他的父母。
But then he gives special attention, he wants Uddhava to give special attention to the gopis.
接着他希望Uddhava特别关注这些gopi们。
So the name Uddhava means, it means a festival.
Uddhava这个名字的字面含义是节日,庆典的,欢庆的。
So, by Krishna sending Uddhava there, is that all the Brijbasi people should feel encouraged. They should feel, oh, festival, festival, Uddhava.
Krishna派Uddhava去这个Vraja,就可以让这些Vrindavan的居民们感觉受到了欢欣鼓舞,哦,节日,节日。
And Krishna is proud to be the son of Nanda and Yashoda. So he wants Uddhava to take this message and to meet with Nanda and Yashoda and make sure they're well and tell them that Krishna's thinking about them.
Krishna希望他作为让Nanda和Yashoda他知道
And he hopes that Nanda and Yashoda, just like they accepted Balaram also as their son, they not only had Krishna as their son, they also thought of Balaram as their son, because Rohini was living there in the home of Nanda and Yashoda, and she had Balaram as a son. So Nanda and Yashoda, they thought Balaram just like their son. So Krishna hopes that they will also accept Uddhava the same way, just like their son. So Uddhava is a very saintly person, he's very humble and he has very pure devotion for Krishna. So that's why Krishna selected him, that he should go and give Nanda Maharaj comfort.
是非常谦逊的，他对Krishna怀着纯洁无瑕的奉爱，所以就被Krishna挑选来去安慰、安抚Nanda和Yashoda。He'll
be able to deliver the message of Krishna very effectively.
他就能有效地来传递Krishna的讯息。And
Uddhava is also, by nature, he's very mild. And Uddhava is also almost as beautiful as Krishna. He looks like Krishna. So when Nanda and Yashoda will see Uddhava, they will feel very pleased just by seeing him. It will pacify their minds.
所以当南娜和亚修多见到乌达瓦的时候，一定会非常的喜悦，他们内心就会得到很大的抚慰。
But at the same time, Krishna knows that to satisfy the minds of the gopis, there will not be enough just for the gopis to see Uddhava or to have Uddhava speak to them. There has to be something more.
但是 Krishna 深知，为了来抚慰这些 gopi 们的内心灵的话，那就仅仅是见到 Uddhava 还不够，而是需要更多的举措。
So the gopis are feeling that pain of separation from Krishna so deeply that just seeing Uddhava will not be enough.
Gopis 们对 Krishna 怀着深深的分离之情，仅仅的看见了 Uddhava 对他们来说还不够。
Krishna has to speak something to the gopis.
Krishna 必须要对 gopis 们说一些话。
It will take Krishna's own words with his own special way of speaking, a special tone which Krishna speaks. That's the only hope to pacify the gopis and also his parents.
Krishna 有自己的特定的言语措辞，他的说话的语调，他的说话的方式，只有他自己这样说话，才能安抚这些勾皮们，并且安抚他的父母。
So Krishna knows his mother and father, Nanda and Yashoda, they'll be happy to hear Krishna's message.
所以他知道，当他的父母听到他的消息的时候，一定会非常的高兴。
But for the gopis, it will only give a little relief.
然而对 gopi 们而言呢，这只能稍许的安抚他们的内心。
The gopis can never feel content in the absence of Krishna.
在 Krishna 不在的情况之下， gopi 们永远不会感到满足。
Okay, so we will stop.
好，那我们正课讲完了，我们来回答问题。第一个问题是 Shruti Rupa Udasi Hare Krishna, 领拜咕噜老师们，请叫咕噜。我们在旅行中见闻到的事情，旅途中我们遇见一个饭店老板，他怎么看都说和我母亲非常熟，而妈妈说一辈子没见过他。后来他告诉我们，他在8岁的时候突然能够准确无误地记忆前世父母家庭的事情，而且也仅限于这一点记忆。请问咕噜，很多奉献者都说我们今生能够走进 Krishna 之觉，是因为前世得到过奉献者的仁慈，那么我们应该以什么样的方法能够最大可能把 Krishna 之觉带给更多不同层信仰层次的人，也成为有利于他们下一世更好回归的因缘呢？Shruti Rupa, it asks that how Krishna obeisance to Guru and teachers. During the journey, we met a boss, hotel boss.
Met what?
He said, they live in the hotel.
Okay.
And the boss said, the boss felt very familiar with Shruti Rupa's mother. Yet, her mother said she never met him before. Later, the boss told Shruti Rupa, their group, that when he was 8 years old,suddenly, he can remember all the previous family situation, the previous mother and father and the family affairs. So her question is that many devotees said that the reason we can enter into Krishna consciousness is because in our previous life, we have got the mercy of devotees. So in which way should we bring Krishna consciousness to more people of different level and different belief? Therefore, to help them in their next life, they can go back in their, help them in their next life.
Yes, well, we can do that by distributing books and by going on Harinam Sankirtan, doing chanting of the holy name, letting people hear about Krishna.
是的,我们可以通过派书,通过Harinam Sankirtan,通过唱诵圣名,让人们听到,聆听到 Krishna.
Of course, we also do things like distribute prasadam to people. So this contact, any contact which people have with devotees is very beneficial for the future life of all these people. We are like farmers, they plant the seeds in the field. So we plant seeds, when we distribute books and we give prasadam, we chant the holy name, we're planting seeds in the hearts of people.
我们就像农夫在田野里在播种，我们派书、派发prasadam、唱诵圣名。
And in the future, these seeds will all fructify. So Lord Chaitanya said, wherever you go, whoever you meet, you tell people about Krishna.
如Chaitanya说，无论你去哪里。
So this is the program of Krishna consciousness, to give people some opportunity that in the future they can also take up Krishna consciousness.
所以这个节目就是。 Krishna之觉的这个节目就是给予人们机会，让他们将来能够接受 Krishna。Krishna
make their life fortunate.
请你让他们的生命变得幸运。 The next part is that, 在旅途中。 旅途中，我们看到很多虔诚的修行藏传佛教的出家人居士，现在还保留着吃肉的习惯。请问，Guru，这样的修行延续到下一世，如果没有遇见奉献者、Krishna奉献者，会不会对灵性回归有帮助呢？ During the journey, we met many pious Tibetan Buddhists, both Grihastha and monks, they still had a habit of eating meat. So Guru, if this kind of practice continued to their next life, if they haven't got a chance to meet with Krishna's devotee, will that be helpful for them, for their spiritual, for them to return spiritual journey of back home, back to Godhead?
Yes, they need the mercy of devotees before they can go back home, back to Godhead.
是的，他们在回归家园、回归神手之前是需要奉献者的仁慈。
They're still eating meat. Of course, they live in Tibet because there's no, it's very hard for them to grow vegetables there. So that's why they all eat meat. There's nothing else to eat.
因为在西藏本来种植蔬菜, 所以他们就吃肉, 他们没办法, 没别的办法。
Of course, they don't need to stay there. They could go and live somewhere where they can grow vegetables. There are many other places in the world to live beside Tibet.
当然了,他们并不需要就是死待在那里,他们也可以去居住在别的地方,他们可以选择世界上其他的地方,并不一定要居住在西藏。
But so long as they eat, eating meat, certainly it's not. So long as you're killing animals, eating meat, you're not going to go back to Godhead.
但是只要他们仍然屠杀动物、吃动物肉的话，是不能回归神手的。 下一个是云南 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. And dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. O Lord Vishnu Prabhupada, the gopis of Vrindavan saw everything in their lives in connection with Krishna. If we constantly remind ourselves that everything in our lives is connected to Krishna, will it help us to progress in Krishna consciousness even though we are not pure devotees and our motives are maybe in Mishra Bhakti, thank you so much. 这个问题是，他们的勾品们在生活当中看到一切都跟Krishna有关系。如果我们不断的提醒自己，我们生活当中的万事万物都跟 Krishna 有关系，这能不能帮助我们在 Krishna 之间中帮助我们进步？ 即便我们还不是奉纯粹奉献者，而且我们的动机还是处在混杂的八体当中。谢谢。
Yes, definitely it will help you. Even though you're not pure, even though you're a mixed devotee, but if you see everything in relation to Krishna, that's very good.
是的，无疑能有帮助。即便您还不纯粹，即便您是混杂的奉献者，但是肯定。 就是对Krishna直接是很有大有帮助的。如果你看到一切跟Krishna有关系。
If you're seeing everything in relation to Krishna, this is not mixed devotion, that is pure devotion.
如果您能看到一切都跟Krishna有关系的话, 那这并不是混杂的奉爱,而是纯洁无暇的奉爱。
So continue to see everything in relation to Krishna.
所以请您继续保持这种视域, 看到万事万物是跟Krishna有关联的。
Yes.
下一个问题是来自于Shama. 顶麦Guru Maharaj, 所有奉献者, 请问Krishna为什么觉得自己无法偿还牧牛姑娘, 只有他的奉献者能做到, 这是为了荣耀他的奉献者吗? Why Krishna felt he cannot repay the gopis? Only his devotees can repay them. Is that to glorify his devotees?
Well, we were explaining why Krishna cannot repay his gopis because Krishna has obligations to many other people beside the gopis.
我们在课程中解释了Krishna为什么无法回报gopi们，因为Krishna还有别的义务，他还除了gopi之外，他还有很多别的奉献者。
Krishna has his mother and father, Nanda and Yashoda. They also love Krishna. They're not just like the gopis, but Krishna, they have great love for Krishna. So Krishna has to also give them some attention. And then Krishna's cows, they're also very affectionate to Krishna. So they're not like the gopis, but Krishna has to also give them some love and care.
But
for the gopis, they have a husband, they have children, they have family. They can only think of Krishna. They can't think of them. They don't think of their husband. They don't think of their families. They just think of Krishna.
而这些勾品们虽然也有自己的丈夫、孩子们，但是勾品们并不想他们，他们只想 Krishna，他们不想自己的家人，不想自己的这些孩子。
And Krishna would sing songs about the beauty of the Vrindavan forest and the beauty of the moon and everything. But the gopis, they only sing about Krishna. They only sing Krishna's name. And they can't think of anything else. Even if they wanted to stop thinking of Krishna, they can't. So Krishna says he cannot love the gopis the way they love him.
So Krishna
That's why he said he cannot repay them. So he told them, you have to be satisfied with your own good qualities.
So Krishna told these gopis, you Krishna 在 Goloka 一直是牧牛童的角色吗? In Goloka, Krishna is always playing the part of a power boy.
Yes.
是的.
That's Krishna's eternal form in the spiritual world. In Goloka, because Goloka is Vrindavan. So in Vrindavan, Krishna is a cowherd boy.
这是Krishna在Goloka的永恒的形象。因为 Krishna在Vrindavan就是一个牧牛童。
When Krishna goes to Dwarka, then he takes a different position. He dresses differently. He shows different ways because it's in Dwarka. It's different from Vrindavan.
Krishna 在 Dwarka, 他就是另外一个地位了。他的穿着举止都不一样，因为 Dwarka 跟 Vrindavan 不同。 Next one.
Yeah.
下一个问题, Bhakta Tom, Hare Krishna, 明白Guru和奉献者们, 所有荣耀归于圣帕帕德。 请问勾品们做事情, 是唱诵Krishna的名, 唱诵Krishna的名字是什么样的歌曲? 他们也会唱诵Mahamantra吗? Hare Krishna, listen to Guru and devotees. When Gopi, they are doing their family duties, they are chanting the name of Krishna. What kind of song is this song? Can they also chant Maha Mantra?
Yes, they can also chant the Maha Mantra.
是的，他们也可以也会唱 Mahamantra。
They will chant the different names. Lord Krishna has many names.
他们主 Krishna 有许多的名字。
We know Lord Chaitanya, he liked to chant.Hare Harae Namma Krishna Yadavaya Namaha Yadavaya Madhavaya Keshavaya Namaha Gopal Govindaram Shri Madhusudan Giridhari Gopinath Madana Mohan. So these kind of songs, this is all the names of Krishna.The gopis could sing these songs about different names of Krishna.
刚才Guru 唱的这个歌曲当中就包含是由 Krishna 不同的名字组成的，而 gopi 们他们也会唱诵这些有关 Krishna 的歌曲。下一个文言。明白孤乳明白您所有奉献者们 Gopi 们为什么不好意思唱诵 Krishna 的名字呢 Why the Gopis are ashamed to chant the name of Krishna?
Well, that was in the presence of the elder people because they don't want the elder people to understand their feelings for Krishna.
这个是他们在长辈们面前的表现因为他们不希望长辈们明白他们对 Krishna 的怀着的这种心思。
The young girls are not supposed to be having, they're not supposed to have relationships or have some attraction to the young men. And if they start singing songs about one of the young men in the village, then the other people, elder people, will say, oh, this girl, she's thinking about this boy Krishna. This is not good. She's not married. And she's thinking about this man, boy. And they'll feel worried.
年轻的姑娘们她们不应该跟别的男孩子有关系不应该被别的年轻的小伙子吸引。如果她们在长辈面前唱着这个歌曲的话这村里的长辈们就会觉得哎，这个姑娘她怎么心里还惦记着别的男孩子吗她们本来都是未婚的少女她们还心里还想着别的孩子男孩所以长辈们就会为她们担心
Yeah, they don't want the elders to know that they have so much deep affection for another young boy.
他们不希望这些长辈们知道他们对另外一个男孩有这么多的深情。
Young girls supposed to be chaste, they're not supposed to be thinking about the young men.
年轻的姑娘们应当是贞洁的，贞洁是如玉的，他们不应当惦记着别的男孩。
The young girls are never allowed to be alone or to go and see young boys.
年轻的姑娘们不应当独自一个人或去见另外一个约会另外一个男孩。
But if they know that the young girl is singing this man's name, they'll think, oh, what's going on? She's having some relationship with this man, with this boy. It's very bad.
如果这些长辈们知道了，他们听到Gopi们唱歌曲当中有他的名字，他们就会想，哎，这怎么回事啊？他们什么关系啊？跟这个男孩子，这个太糟糕了。
Then they'll take care to keep the girl away from that boy.
啊，他们就会格外的留心，把他们两个人分开。
Okay.
下一个。Number 五，顶拜孤乳，顶拜您。奉献者的躯体里有超灵，非奉献者也有超灵，灵性导师。 奉献者交给Krishna管吗？非奉献者归阎罗王管吗？ 灵性，Sati这是什么意思？ 灵性岛。 In the body of devotee, there are super soul reside in the body of both devotees and non-devotees. Is that devotees are taken care of by Krishna and non-devotees are taken care of by Yamaraj?
Yes, certainly. If you're a pure devotee, then Krishna will take care of you.
是的，肯定的，无疑。如果您是纯粹奉献者，Krishna会照顾你。
Of course, devotee doesn't like that Krishna has to take care of them. Devotee likes to take care of Krishna.
但奉献者们，他们不喜欢 Krishna 来照顾他们。 奉献者们喜欢照顾Krishna。
We think of Krishna as our child or as our friend, and we want to take care of him.
他们把Krishna当成孩子，当成朋友，然后悉心地照料他。
We don't like to give, to take service, we like to give service.
我们不喜欢来接受服务，反过来我们希望来给予服务。
So those people who are not devotees, Krishna's in their heart also, and of course Krishna, we said Krishna is the super soul, he's a witness to all of their activities.
在非奉献者的内心也居住着超灵，他们体内作为见证者，见证他们的一举一动。
So at the time of death, then they will have to go to Yamaraj.
在死亡之际，他们不得不去见阎罗王。
And the super soul was the witness to all of their activities. They may not confess to Yamaraj that they did so many bad things, but the super soul was a witness. He saw all the things they did.
超灵在他们身体里就是一个见证者，当他们见到阎罗王的时候，他们可能不承认，死不承认他们干过的坏事，但是超灵会已经见证了他们活着的时候的所有的所作所为。Anyway,
the super soul is there along with the living entity, and he's giving knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness.
无论如何，超灵都在生物的居住在他们心中，他给予他们知识、记忆、遗忘。So
as long as the living entity desires to still enjoy the material world, the super soul allows the living entity to forget about Krishna consciousness.
只要生物还渴望享受物质世界，超灵就会允许生物来。
But gradually, the living entity experiences more and more difficulty in trying to find pleasure in the material world.
逐渐的，生物体就会发现，在物质世界寻找快乐就越来越难。
And so at that time, the super soul gives guidance and can help us to find the solution to the problems.
在那个时候，超灵就会给予指导，帮助我们找到这些问题的答案。
We may meet a devotee and we get a Bhagavad Gita, so then we start to read it and we think more. About spiritual knowledge.
他就会遇见奉献者，读到了国家梵歌，他就会仔细的思索，来寻求探求灵性知识。
And we hear about the sinful souls, how they go to Yamaraj and how they're put in hell in so many different conditions to suffer for all their sins.
我们也听到那些罪恶的灵魂，他们会去见阎罗王，也会下到地狱里来为他们所做的罪恶活动受苦。
So we become more thoughtful and more careful about our lifestyle.
这样一来呢，我们对自己的生活方式就会有更深入的思考，就会更加小心谨慎了。
Yes, okay.
下一个 Galaxy 和佛教徒一起念阿弥陀佛，然后再唱诵 Krishna， 就会引发他们对至尊主的皈依吗？我也不用说什么，咱们的哲学就可以吗？ Can I chant Amitabha with those Buddhists, and later on we can chantKrishna in that way to conduct them to surrender to the Supreme Lord. So I do not need to see any philosopher. Is that okay?
Yes, if you get them to chant Hare Krishna, that's very good.
是的，如果您能让他们唱 Hare Krishna, 我非常棒了。
That is our real purpose in preaching, to get everyone to chant the holy name.
这是我们传播的真正目的所在，让每个人都唱诵圣名。
So you're the best preacher.
您是最棒的传播者。
Okay.
下一个。Honor, be, 顶拜布鲁，顶拜您，所有奉献者。达木达尔月的第一天和最后一天，供奉33盏灯是权威规定的吗？达木达尔月的最后五天都遵守 Bhishma Panchaka 吗 ？Even the first day and the last day, offering 33 lamps, is it?authorized injunction?
No.
不是权威规定的。
Never heard this before.
从来以前没听说过。
Every day we offer one lamp.
每天我们供奉一盏灯。Also, should we follow Bhishma Panchaka during the last 5 days of Kartik month?
Well, Bhishma Panchak is not compulsory.
就是这个 Bhishma Panchaka 不是必须的，强制性的，不是。
But if somebody...feels that they didn't follow Kartik, they didn't follow the 4 months of austerity very well, they may like to do the Bhishma Panchak.
倘若有人觉得他没有好好的过Kartik 月，没有好好的过四月苦行，他们可能会觉得需要去遵守这 Bhishma Panchak.
But it's not an obligation. You don't have to do Bhishma Panchak.
但这不是强制性的，不是必须要过这个 Bhishma Panchaka。
If you like to do it, you can do it.
如果你喜欢的话，可以去过。下一个是 Jaya Govinda Devadasi， 顶拜亲爱的 Guru。昨天我去给一个 我去给一个认识多年的非奉献者朋友送一些不杀的，公园一起散步，告诉他念诵圣名吃素的好处，他也表现很好，愿意脱口念诵，一大堆好奇问题。当这位姐姐的身体离我很近的时候，我内心升起一种抵触的心理，不愿意她靠我太近，当时的感觉好挣扎，希望快点中断聊天离开现场。你们姑姑，我这样的心态是不是不太恰当呢？谢谢你。Yesterday, I have a non-devotee friend, and yesterday, I know her for many years. Yesterday, I sent some prasadam to her, and we took a walk in the park. I told her the benefits to chant holy name and to be vegetarian, and her behavior is quite good, and she was willing to chant.And she had a lot of inquisitive questions. But when this elder sister's buddy approached me, I had the feeling of repulsive feeling in my
heart. What feeling?
Rejection, repulsive. I do not want her to approach me very near. The distance.I felt very struggling, the feeling is very struggling. I hope to cut off the talks and leave her. So, Guru, is this, I want to ask Guru, is this attitude proper or not?
Well, she didn't mention...What this person was like. Was this person against the practice of devotional service? She didn't say anything. She just said she just had a feeling about the person. We didn't hear anything about what the person did or said. So I don't know.
那您也没有特别具体的，就是说这个人他的生活到底是怎么过的？他生活当中做了些什么？他曾经是做过些什么事？他曾经说过些什么话？他到底反对，会不会反对奉爱服？所以我没法给你一个确切的答案。
Yeah, we have to know what, you know, we cannot just go by feelings. There has to be some...justification for actions.
我们不能凭感情用事，我们采取行动必须要有理有据的。下一个，狗让给明白咕噜，明白您。达摩大月快到了，家里有好多突袭干支，怎么给主在这供灯的时候供奉呢？During the Kartika event, we have many dry tulsi branches. How can we use them when we offer lamps to the Lord?
They have many dry fruits.
No, branch.When the tulsi left her body?
Yes. Well, she can put cotton, wrap some cotton around the dry branches and put the oil or put the ghee onto the cotton and then use it to burn as an offering to Damodar.
那您可以在这个 tulsi 干枝的四周就用棉花缠上棉花然后浸泡在油里或是酥油，就是当您供给达摩达尔供灯的时候，就供奉。
Okay.
Next question is the dragon. Oh, that's all.
That's all.
Yes. That's all the questions. Yeah, finish all the questions.
Okay, so then we'll stop here today.
Okay, no, sorry. No one question. 奉献者们好，可以问个事儿怎么起？She wants to know how, what's the procedure for getting initiated?
Well, the procedure is that you should attend the disciple course. There's a special course which just takes a few days called the ISKCON Disciple Course. And you should attend that course, and in that course they explain to you what is the procedure for initiation.
有一个课程就叫做 ISKCON 门徒课程，只需要几天的时间。您需要参加这个课程，在这个课程当中解释了怎么得到启迪。
There are some procedures and requirements before you get initiation.
在您获得启迪之前。有一些程序的，有一些要求。
First, most important is you have to be strictly following four principles, and you have to be chanting 16 rounds every day.
那么最重要的就是要严格遵守四项原则，每天念诵16圈。
And then you should be, associating with devotees sometimes.
您还需要有时候跟奉献者联谊。
You should be hearing the classes like we're having every morning.
那您需要聆听每天的早课。
And then you have to be doing this for a period of time. There's a certain period, time period, that you have to be following the four principles and chanting 16 rounds for a minimum period of at least 6 months. And then you can think about taking initiation.
在您考虑去获得启迪之前，要必须要唱诵十六圈，严格遵守四项原则，至少六个月，半年的时间。
So then, if you take, you know, you regularly, we have the ISKCON Disciple Course online, and you can attend that course, and you can hear everything, and you can also ask questions more.
我们有在线的ISKCON 门徒课程。那您可以聆听，然后在课上问问题。
But this course is compulsory for anybody who's taking initiation in ISKCON.
谁在 ISKCON 当中想要获得启迪，这个课程是必须的，必须参加的。
I think there's a course beginning very soon, before the end of the month. So you can inquire from some devotee there, they can guide you.
那么很快就是在月底之前就要开办这样一期门徒课了，那你可以询问奉献者们并且得到相应的指导。
Okay, thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Yes, that's all the question. They said thank you so much.
Okay, Vaman Ganshi Guru Mani, Ki Vaman Jangtai Defani, Ganshi Soya Defang Shensa T1, Vaman Jufu Niman, Chansong Kwaila. Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Yeah.
Go back to Vrindaki.
Yes.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you, Guru.
Vaikuntha Jin, 服务员听，非常非常感谢圣巴比维克米纳什纳斯拉斯瓦玛拉给我们带来精彩讲。